some point she had to hear about Jesus. Amen. And that's the thing we need to understand. She had to hear about Jesus.
Right.
Amen. She probably heard about Jesus, amen, about the man that was healed, amen, the demonic that was healed, amen, delivered, amen, amen, suffering, amen. She suffered physically, amen. She had this constant blood loss. Think about it. Physically, she had to be weak, amen. Physically, she was an outcast. She couldn't come in the city. She was supposed to stand outside. If she asked for food, like it's at the back wall, she had to yell out, and then someone would put it like halfway, and they would step back, and she would go get it. She suffered physically from this. Amen? And think about it. She tried all the remedies of the current age from the doctors. Amen? Amen. I was looking at some of the remedies, and just listen to this, some of the things that they told her she might want to do. We might do, amen. Take the gum of Alexandria, of alum, and crocus hortensis, the way the Zuzi eats, and let them be bruised together, and give them wine to the woman. And then see, here's the thing, that doesn't even make sense. Amen. I don't know about you, that doesn't even make sense. You know, this is just a bunch of people trying to make things up, amen. But then they say, if that don't work, try this. They give her another remedy. If that don't work, try this. Amen. I know I was looking at Dr. Field the other day, and there was a woman on there. Man, she had some problems. Serious problems. Every problem, it stressed her family out, so that's why she was on Dr. Field. But she ended up, she was on 70 medications. She was zoned out, and then she didn't know what medication to take. The daughter was like, I need a mother, I need a mother. So the daughter was mad. The husband was just helping her, amen, much as he can. Think about that. Cannot function. Then they asked her if she wanted to be delivered.
All right.
She wanted to get off all the drugs. You know what she said? No. Familiarity. She was familiar with that situation, amen? And to step out of that familiar situation into the unknown, well, she was fearful of that. Mm-hmm. And so that's something we have to think about. Sometimes, amen, we're more afraid to step out of a current situation into something new.
All right.
Amen.
All right.
And sometimes to step out and stepping out on faith is a big step, amen. Tell your neighbor, stepping out on faith, that's a big step, amen. Amen, you know, but faith is the substance of things hoped for. What are you hoping for out of this situation? What do you hope to gain? Amen, what do you hope to be? Amen, you know, this woman, she said she couldn't see it, but they showed her 3 months after they showed her 3 months later, like a whole different person. Amen. She was off the drugs. She had a clear mind. She could think for herself. Amen. But today, nowadays, a lot of these symptoms that we have are related to stress. We stress ourselves out, busying ourselves, running here, running there. Amen. And it comes out physically on our bodies. Amen. So we need to think. Amen. Physically, amen, when we're stressed out, what do we need to do? Turn it over to Jesus, amen. Grab the hem of his garment in faith and hold on, amen. So the woman also, she suffered three more areas. She suffered socially. Why is it socially? Because she couldn't be married. If she touched her husband, she defiled her husband, amen. So socially, she could not be married. No physical contact at all, amen. Emotionally, amen, since she had been this way for 12 years, think about the toll on her mind this had taken, amen. She had lived her life moving from one rejection to another. We think about our lives. How many times have we been rejected, amen, emotionally, amen? How many times have we been turned down emotionally, amen? And then she want to make this big step toward Jesus, amen. Fear of rejection is something of itself, amen.
Right.
That's a great big risk, amen.
Right.
Fear of the unknown. I don't know if he's going to heal me. I don't know if he's going to tell me to step back, that you shouldn't be touching me. I don't know, but she took, you know, it takes courage,
yes.
Amen. Courage, or it takes you coming to the end of your rope,
right,
and saying, I am determined and I am desperate to be healed,
right,
of this disease.
All right.
I want to see Jesus.
All right.
The miracles he's done.
Uh-huh.
I understand that he delivered, amen, this young man. I understand that, amen, he raised the dead. Amen. I understand that he has done these things. Amen. But when we understand that he has done these things, praise God, we still have to have courage. Amen.
Yeah.
Big courage. Amen. And she suffered religiously. Because under the law, she was considered unclean.
Right.
Amen. And then if she touched anyone, she was considered, they were considered to be defiled. If the crowd knew, tell your neighbor, if the crowd knew.
Right.
If the crowd knew who she was, amen.
Right.
If the crowd saw
right.
what she was doing. Because she had to make her way through the crowd.
Right.
And you know, she probably had to push a little, so she touched, made him undefiled.
Right.
Amen. She touched somebody to get by.
Yes.
She tried to slide by, but pushing and shoving, amen. Then you're going to get touched, amen.
Right.
If they knew who she was, there's a possibility they would have turned on her.
Right.
And they would have stoned her. And they would have killed this woman, amen, just because, amen, she was not where she should have been, amen, away from them, amen, amen. So we think about, she had spent all she had, and the useless remedies had not even helped her at all. Amen, let's go on, amen, can I get a reader for verse 27?
When he had heard Jesus came into Bethany and touched his garment.
Yes, she came through the crowd. Amen. I think I kind of moved ahead. Amen. But, amen. She came in the crowd. And, amen, touched his garment. Amen. If we look, how many times do we feel that, amen, we need to touch the hem of Jesus' garment?
All right. All right.
What situations do we face?
Right.
I shouldn't say situation. I should say what issues are we facing
right.
that we haven't brought before Jesus?
Right.
Sometimes, in spite of the church being crowded, in spite of, amen, it looks like something else and somebody may be talking about you and say, well, I got to get to Jesus.
Uh-huh.
I've got to make my way and get in his presence. Because in his presence is fullness of joy.
Yeah.
At his right hand, pleasures anymore. You think about the end of the story, because I know y'all know the story.
Yes.
She got what she wanted.
Yeah, right.
But she had to have an audience with the king.
Yeah.
She had to get in the presence of Jesus.
Yeah.
There was no other way she could see that this could happen except to press through the crowd.
Mm.
Press through her issues.
Yeah.
Okay. Press through her situations.
Right.
Press through her work schedule.
Right.
Press through lack of finances, amen. Press through, amen. Sometimes we just gotta press, amen. Sometimes we just gotta make our way, amen. Press through what people may say about you. Press through, amen, amen, what people are doing through to you, amen. We got to make a press and get to Jesus, amen. We get that audience with Jesus. Look at what can happen, praise God.
Right.
Amen. Get him in the midst. Amen. Verse 28, I'll read. For she said, if I may touch what is closed, I shall be made whole.
Amen.
She said, I shall be made whole. Look at this. If you look at all the New Testament, how many other times do you see where Jesus, someone was healed because they touched the hem of his garment or his clothes. This is the only instance, amen? But this instance, amen, it was understood why she had to do it the way she did it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Why she had to press through the crowd to get to Jesus and just secretly hold on to that garment.
All right.
She had to do it in faith, amen?
Right, right.
She had to do it, amen, and with great faith. Amen, because if she didn't do it in faith, amen, she could be killed.
All right.
You know, he was at the head of the crowd. He wasn't at the back.
All right.
Think about where she probably stood. She probably stood over at the door, and the crowd's all up here. She had to make her way. And it didn't say she came up the side. It didn't say she came up the middle. But either way it go,
amen.
She got there. Amen.
All right. All right. Yeah.
How many of us can identify with this woman today? Amen. How many can see situations, amen, that are just encroaching upon you and you don't know what to do? Amen. I can't see how I'm going to be delivered. It's an impossible situation. I don't see how I'm going to come out of it. Amen. But we got to understand. We got to have that fortitude like this woman. Press our way. Press our way.
Yeah.
Look, this woman paints a clear picture of every every person that first off that doesn't know Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
They don't know they need Jesus Christ, but right. They sure can hear a word. Amen. We can go tell somebody about Jesus.
That's right.
Because the way she came, she had to hear about Jesus.
Right.
She had to understand that somebody said, well, I got healed. Amen. He healed me. Amen. They let me down through the roof. Amen. And I got healed. Amen. She had to hear about the demonic that got delivered who lived among the tombs.
Right. Right.
Somebody came and told her. Amen. How many of us are sharing our testimonies?
Oh,
amen. Telling somebody about the goodness of Jesus.
All right.
Amen.